Hypothesis tests for mu, one mean. We will continue to look at the variable in C5, continuous 1. We know that the population standard deviation, sigma, is equal to 20. We want to compute a hypothesis test to see if the true population mean of continuous 1 is different from 160. So it's a two-sided hypothesis test when sigma, the population standard deviation, is known. To perform this in Minitab, go to the Stat menu, Basic Statistics, One Sample Z. If sigma was not known, we would go to One Sample T. To perform the hypothesis test, we first need to enter C5 as our samples and columns. The standard deviation is sigma, the population standard deviation, that is given as 20. Next, we need to tell Minitab to perform the hypothesis test and enter the null value. We wanted to see if the true population mean was different from 160. So that's the null value. Next, we can click the Options button to select our alternative hypothesis direction. If we want to see if the true mean is different from 160, that's a two-sided test, and the alternative hypothesis should be not equal. Minitab will also give us a confidence interval. When we click OK, at the end of the output, we can see the p-value for the hypothesis test. Underneath the Z is the test statistic. Let's change our situation just a little bit. Let's say we wanted to do a one-sided test to see if the true population mean is greater than 160, and we don't know sigma, the population standard deviation. In order to do that hypothesis test, we need to go back to the Stat menu, under Basic Statistics, choose One Sample T. Enter the variable we're dealing with, that's continuous 1. We want to check the box to perform the hypothesis test. Here we need to enter the hypothesized mean of 160. That's the null value. We can go in the options box to make sure that the alternative hypothesis is what we want. If we wanted to show that the true mean was greater than 160, we need to choose greater than for the alternative hypothesis. Now the output shows that our test statistic is a T statistic. After that is the p-value.